All right, let's get straight to the point. Setting up WeChat is definitely more complicated than Alipay. That's one of the clearest things I realized while making this video. So for travelers visiting China for the first time, I'll give you a very straightforward answer. Use Alipay as your primary payment method in China. All right, now comes the crucial part. The first thing you absolutely must know, many people think that WeChat and Weixin are the same app, and that Weixin is just the Chinese name for WeChat. But actually, their ecosystem are very different. Some key functionalities are exclusive to each version. For example, Weixin offers more advanced features in payments and the discovery page, while WeChat does not. On the other hand, WeChat supports Cockpit and WeChat Auth, which Weixin doesn't, among other differences. Additionally, they operate on separate servers managed by different teams, and their data is stored in the different data centers. This means that each version applies different standards for filtering sensitive content and follows its own privacy policy, if you know what I mean. Let's break it down. Here are the key differences between them. You have 3 seconds to take a screenshot. 3, 2, 1. Naturally, this leads to another question. Which one should I choose? And how do I get the version I want? WeChat or Weixin? Here's the answer. If you don't already have a mainland Chinese SIM card number, you don't have a choice. That's because whether you get WeChat or Weixin is automatically determined by SIM card number. Note that what is mentioned here is SIM card number. A physical SIM card is not necessarily required, but you must be able to receive text message. Some people may wonder how it is possible to receive text messages without a physical number. The answer is that your foreigner friends can help you with the text messages, or some virtual cards can provide text messages through web pages or other means. In reality, both WeChat and Weixin use the same app installer, no matter where you download it from, whether you search for Weixin or WeChat. You'll get the same app package. If you register or link the app with the mainland Chinese SIM number, you'll get Weixin. If you use an overseas SIM card number, you'll get WeChat. Good news is, users on both platforms can communicate seamlessly, and the app also supports data migration and version switching. For example, if you originally used an overseas SIM card and later switched to a Chinese SIM card, your app can automatically convert from WeChat to Weixin. For short-term travelers, WeChat is more than enough to cover food, transport, shopping, and daily payments in China. You can use it for the most things. For long-term travelers, you can start with WeChat and then register a Weixin account once you obtain a mainland SIM card. Note that what I'm talking about here is registering a new Weixin account, not converting your new WeChat account to Weixin. That's because WeChat requires a new account to wait at least 180 days before it can be switched. Obviously, for new WeChat users, it's more convenient to directly register a new Weixin account. In mainland China, Weixin is much more powerful than WeChat. Only Weixin lets you truly experience life in China as a local. All right, we've covered the most important things. Let's get into the hands-on setup part. Register, verify, and link a bank card. Note that here we are focusing on WeChat, not Weixin. If you have any questions about Weixin version, drop them in the comments below. 1. Registration. You should absolutely set up WeChat before you leave your home country, because SMS verification and app downloading will be easy there. As mentioned before, the app version you get is determined by your register SIM card number, not the installation package or your physical location. In this demo, I'm using a UK virtual number in mainland China, so I got a WeChat account, not Weixin. On the first page, you will see an option, Sign up via Facebook. I wouldn't recommend using that if you are going to mainland China. You should know that some services are blocked on the Chinese internet, like Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, ChatGPT, Chrome, Gmail, Google Earth, Binance, Telegram, and so on. So for a smooth trip, do not register using Facebook, even if you have a VPN. Click Sign Up via mobile. Choose the region that matches your phone number, not your current location. Here's the something odd. When I selected the UK the first time, currency showed up. It was only on the second try that United Kingdom appeared. If you know why, let me know in the comments. Enter your phone number and set a login password. Be sure to remember this password. You will rarely use it again. It's really easy to forget. I forgot mine the next day. Here, you'll be asked to pass the security check. I failed the first time for no reason, but I retried immediately and passed. Next, you may encounter the friend verification page. This is unique to WeChat and is designed to prevent bots from mass registering accounts. It also helps establish your first social connection on the platform. There is a more than 50% chance that you'll see this. Three things to note here. One, if you encounter this page once, it will keep showing up no matter how many times you restart the process. Two, your helper does not have to be Chinese. Any existing WeChat user will do. Three, if you are registering a second WeChat account, you can use your own first account to verify the second one. That's what I did. Each WeChat account can help others only 3 times per year. Helping strangers is risky. If the new account is used for illegal activities like money laundering, fraud, gambling, or spreading prohibited content, the helper's account may be permanently banned or flagged as high risk. If the case is serious, the helper could face credit damage or even legal investigation. So unfortunately, I can't offer to help most people with friend verification. You'll need to find your friend who already has a WeChat account. And once you have your own account, it's best to only help with verification for close family and friends you personally know and trust. After friend verification, WeChat will send an SMS code to your phone. Enter the code, set a nickname, upload a profile picture, and enter your real birth date. This may be required for future identity checks. When asked to allow access to your contact list, I suggest no granting it for now. You can always enable it later if needed. Camera and microphone access can be granted. You will see the latest version of WeChat's terms and privacy policies. Confirm your birth date again. You won't be able to change it later. Here you will see that my data as a UK user is stored in Amsterdam. I have read and understand the above. I have read and acknowledged the privacy policy. All right, you have just completed your registration. Everything else on the setup screen can be skipped for now. You can always enable or disable those options later. Now we move on to the step 2, linking a bank card and completing identity verification. In WeChat, real name verification is done during the bank card linking process, so we'll go straight to that. To link a bank card, you can either go through the money section or the wallet section. Here, we tap on wallet, then tap bank cards, and then add a bank card. Now you'll see a list of international cards currently supported by WeChat. Visa, Master, American Express, JCB, Discover, Diners, and UnionPay International. This list is exactly the same as Alipay's pose. Enter your card number and system will automatically detect the card type. Next, you'll be taken to the bank card and personal information form. This includes your name, ID type, ID number, and phone number. Make sure the phone number you enter here is the one linked to your bank card, not the one you use to register your WeChat account. As for address and occupation, these fields don't need to be super accurate. Just give a general answer and it should be fine. Next, agree to privacy policy and bank contract. Then the bank will send a verification code via SMS to the phone number tied to your card. Enter the code and now you arrive at the face verification step. In my case, it actually took about 6 tries to pass this step. I was recording the video at the time, so maybe the lighting or some obstruction caused issues. Try adjusting your angle or removing your glasses. That's what finally worked for me. After that, you'll be asked to set a payment password. Choose something secure but easy for you to remember. You need this password every time you make a payment. Once you've set your password, tap Next, and you'll see verification complete. At this point, you've successfully linked your first bank card and you are now able to make payments through WeChat. To test it out, I made a small transfer to myself using another account I own, and it worked. If you'd like to test whether your card works properly, feel free to contact me via email. I can help you test it by sending or receiving a very small amount. By the way, if too many people try this, my account might trigger risk control. So let's see how it goes. There's one more thing to remind you. After going into my wallet, at the very bottom, you see something called ID Info. Tap that and you arrive at the identity information page. Here, you'll probably notice that the ID photo section is still marked to be uploaded. I suggest that you go ahead and upload this ID photo proactively. Alright, that completes our entire process of linking a bank card and testing the payment function. Now you can start exploring more features on WeChat. Finally, congrats! You have a WeChat account. My job here is done. See you next time. Bye-bye.